guys, here it is. Look at that mess. So I got lucky enough and I was able to check over here in the corner, and most of our wetness came right here at the base of the step. So I came over here in the corner and I was able to get underneath the carpet. It was just tack stripped down, that's it. So I peeled it back, I took that. I was also able to get the padding out as well. And look at this mess. Absolutely a freaking mess. But yeah, so I've got four fans on it. I've got a good little air mover over here on the focused on the really bad spot. I came down here with the shop vac. I was able to get probably a good gallon or so out of that. I mean, you guys can see there's water in there. Definitely was a good idea to get the shop vac involved. Definitely kind of extracted out of the carpet, but it was a little too late. And so what I did in the last 2 hours or so is I actually cut the padding. The padding is cheap, it's easily replaceable, and even if it is dry, we can just put it back together. You could tell originally they had some, I'll call it liquid nails. I'm not sure what they actually used right there in areas to keep it down. So at worst, I come back and I do that. But so I cut that, I threw it in the garage, let it start drying. So because you can imagine, it's just gonna get wet on the rug, and you can see where it's still wet. That's not gonna get dry at all. So piece of advice, try to rip that carpet up. Obviously, if I have to bring the professionals out here to relay it, bring their little knee kickers and all that stuff, you know, so be it. At least we're getting dry. I actually did have Serpro come out here, and they actually tested right here in this spot, and they said there is no wetness in the drywall, just a little bit from the baseboard to where it was actually making contact with the carpet. So we're good there. I'm not sure what, you know, if I've got a gap behind here that's not allowing it to get wet, which is phenomenal news for us. But nonetheless, so I ripped it up as much as I could, got it draped over a party chair over there. I'm trying to get some air under all this spot. So we got a box fan under there blowing this way. I've got another fan back there, get some air to the carpet. And we've got this fan trying to dry out this pad, what's left of this little bit of pad. And then we'll focus really on this area next. But guys, I just wanted to show you. I mean, I did Google and YouTube a video or two on this. I haven't had a whole lot of time, but yeah, they came down here, man. It was hot, it was humid. It was, as soon as we rounded the basement, it hit you like a brick wall. It's kind of starting to go out the last 2 hours or so, but Serpro, even the guys there said, you know what, you really don't need a dehumidifier, but that's definitely one of the things you might want. All right, guys, we're back after that quick little splice. This is a couple weeks removed. We did have a little bit more extensive water damage come in. We were able to still get all the carpet up, get all the pad out. You can see the extent of how far it actually made it this time. It was originally just kind of focused over in this area, but it ended up growing so much that we had to keep going. We just had so much rain out here. So anyway, just wanted to kind of make sure you guys took away one point. I was starting to say something about dehumidifiers in the other video. Of course, dehumidifiers are gonna pull out all that extra moisture and air out of the water at pretty high rates. They do pretty well, but man, they're expensive. I mean, you know, even the cheapo ones are running $300-$400. But you know, you could rent them from Home Depot. You could go buy them at Lowe's, wherever you want. What's cool about it, you know, is you go to Home Depot, rent them for a couple hours rather than actually, you know, putting out $400 for a dehumidifier, and which most companies don't even sell really good ones. You know, you're gonna have to order them. So, you know, obviously that's not gonna work for you if you're in a big bind like I was. But anyway, the biggest thing you can take away from this video is get to that corner. Definitely the corner is going to be one of the weakest spots that you could get. If you need to get some needle-nose pliers, come down here and grab the carpet so you can pull it up. I would say get that carpet, pull it up as much as you possibly can, and see the extent of the damage that's going to be on that underneath carpet pad. And of course, take a razor blade, scissors, whatever you've got, score it, cut it, get that pad out of wherever your problem area is, get it drying in a garage or outside, drape it over something so that it just falls out and then it can start to dry. If you just let it, you know, lie flat, it's just gonna sit there and sit and stew in itself. So I mean, that you gotta drape it over stuff. But if you can get that carpet pad out of here, get to that straight, whether you've got a it shouldn't be hopefully a subfloor, but if you got concrete or subfloor, then you'd be able to actually start getting that dry so that you could, you know, then bring some people out to either relay it. You know, and the greatest thing about If you can get that corner up, pulled up, or wherever you're at, you know, cut that pad. You know, depending on however big it is, it's not that big of a deal to you know, glue down a you know, small patch of the carpet pad. You know, you can't really stitch in carpet, you know, if you ruin it and need to replace, you got to replace the whole thing. So if you can just get that carpet out, you know, get it to where you can get that pad out of here, cut it, let it all dry, come back together, put it all back together later on. But that's just one thing I want you guys to take away from this video, mostly. And as always, if you guys got any comments you want to add down there, let me know. And I hope you guys will never have to deal with anything like this. But if you do, here's a small little video for you guys. And I hope it works. And I hope it helps you all. And as always, feel free to comment, like, subscribe to us. And I can't wait to see you guys in the next one. Later, guys.